It is a pleasure to have here with us today, Fernando Segal. We're here to talk about the Professional Tennis Player Association.
This new association promises to improve the overall conditions for the players. They claim that many are getting hurt from the amount of mandatory tournaments, and they also feel disrespected by the bureaucracy. Most players don't have a voice or vote in decision-making, especially with the supermajority rule. Fernando, all this controversy started 2 or 3 days ago. What can you tell us about it?
Yeah, this is a big impact in terms of the moment, you know, but probably could be a perfect moment too, you know, because sometimes big changing has to start in some way. I think the idea of the ATP when they started, probably 40 years ago, was pretty good to bring together tournaments and players. But probably too, in these new generations and new time, we need to innovate. We need to change, you know? And Djokovic tried to create a momentum to develop a new things and bring in a lot of players like Isner, Pospisil, Sanquere, signed yesterday, and a lot of Schwarman from Argentina, Pella from Argentina, players from all over the world. They started to be involved in that. This is not a new idea. This is an idea that was in place for many, many years, you know, but because always the tournaments and the players are like a conflict or interest between them, because it's very difficult, you know, to share the same objectives, the owners of the tournaments, or even the Grand Slams. And also, if you take that, sometimes all the big decisions are not taken for all the players. You take that, the comparison between the benefits or the revenue, the Grand Slams, yeah, if you compare the money that they put for the players, it's like 25%. I don't know if this is the solution. But I think the Djokovic and the players wants to start to create that all the players receive more benefits, be attended, because we know that it's very difficult sometimes to talk with a big organization.
You saw the response from the other part of the tour that didn't agree with them. They feel that this is the wrong time. People involved in the industry, they don't understand what's really going on.
My impression on the two letters, the Djokovic letter and the letter of signed by Nadal, Federer, Anderson, Bruno Suarez, all those guys, I think was made it by someone else, you know. I think the letter of Djokovic is probably write it for himself, you know, and some probably some advices, but anyway, it's more like a guy telling to the others which are the type of intention, and you know, and the other was more structural response. Gaudenzi is the right way to be in the ATP. Unfortunately, the situation with the pandemic situation, all the things, he's coming from the entertainment industry, and probably in the big leagues, we need more to be close to events and entertainment concerts. I think there is a big, big gap between players and tournaments.
You know, tennis has many bodies. Now, how can the players negotiate with so many different bodies? Is that a reality or is that a dream?
Probably right now it's more a dream like reality, because this is one of the weaknesses of international tennis. Too much politics, 7 organizations running different interests. Probably everyone can be right on that, you know, but if you have the 4 Grand Slams, you have the WTA, the ITF, and the ATP, and also on the Olympics.
Do you think that this association will get together with the WTA or any of the WTA players?
All the communication right now is only for the men's side. But anyway, I think if they can be really worried about tennis and universal concept of tennis, they have to work together with the women's side.
There are many players that say that this is the wrong time. Djokovic seems to think that this is the right time. Novak, we would love to invite you so you can explain to us what's in your mind.